The round robin and hot potato are brainstorming activities that involve students working together to generate new ideas, lists, or new data in a short period of time. A round robin involves the whole class working on the same topic, whereas a hot potato involves the class working on multiple subtopics. Group students in 3 to 5 at a table with one piece of paper and one person to record per table. For a round robin, all groups respond to the same topic. If a hot potato was being used to conduct, say, a KWHL on natural disasters, each group would have a different subtopic, such as earthquakes, cyclones, volcanoes, and tidal waves. Explain to the students that you expect this activity to be noisy, as there will be lots of discussion in generating ideas. It is important to stress that every idea is written down. In this activity, the groups are generating possible ways to reduce the incidence of sun cancer. At the signal from the teacher, each group begins their brainstorming with one student from each group recording the ideas generated. Stop the activity after about 90 seconds and ask the students to move the pieces of paper one table to the left. A student in each team reads the responses from the previous table. Then the group continues to generate and record more ideas on the new piece of paper. There are two important rules once the students receive the new sheet of paper. One person must read all the responses to the rest of the group. And two, students add more ideas to the new sheet, but they must not repeat what they have added to the previous sheet. After 2 minutes, stop the activity and move the paper to the left again. Remember, students must not repeat what they have previously recorded. Repeat this process for about 4 to 5 rotations. There are many ways in which you can value add to the round robin. Once the brainstorming ends, each group can rank the best 3 or 4 ideas. Alternatively, students can state their answers in terms of a classification that you have designed, such as the most creative ideas or the most important dates. By adding this extra step, students will have the raw material to create a structured report, essay, poem, or PowerPoint presentation. These responses can then be discussed and recorded, or alternatively, developed with other strategies such as the elimination draw, Y chart, or PCQ. This learning strategy generates a large amount of energy and ensures that everyone is successful, as new ideas are readily developed with each rotation through piggybacking. There is also an understanding that each student needs to contribute to avoid letting the group down. Even shy students respond well to this brainstorming activity.